Hello, my BFF1000 Nation. How's everyone doing today? Hopefully, everyone's having a great day. If not, I hope it gets better from here. We are back with another Mr. Ballin video. This one is titled The Disturbing Case of the SS Orang Medan. I probably butchered every word in that sentence, and I'm okay with that. All right. This was actually requested by a viewer, and I'm kind of excited. Only time I've ever heard the word Medan in anything is Man of Medan. And it was a pretty fucked up game. So, I'm really intrigued. Alright. If you guys are intrigued as I am, please go ahead, turn them lights down low, put on something comfy, color up with something special. Let's get intrigued. I feel intrigued. Inquisitive. Let's get inquisitive.
Yeah. In 1947, a disturbing distress signal was sent out kind of in all directions, like a blind distress signal from some point in the Indian Ocean. Numerous American, Dutch, and English ships, along with other international listening stations, heard this distress signal. And once they triangulated where it was coming from, they sent out a search party to go see who needed help. When they arrived on scene, they discovered something that would become one of the most famous maritime mysteries of all time. This is the story of the SS Orang Medan. What's going on, guys? Mr. Ballin here. I was a Navy SEAL for a little while, and now I tell strange, dark, and mysterious stories on the internet. YouTube is...
Sir, I am from the future, and I just want to go ahead and tell you, you have become a powerhouse, bro.
Is my new passion, and I'm going to be posting at least 2 times a week going forward. And if you like this kind of content, please right now hit like on this video and subscribe to my channel, turn on notifications so you don't miss any of this stuff. Thank you very much.
Yeah, and if you like his video, I'm technically kind of into, so go ahead down there and like mine too.
Very much. Before we get into the story, I want you guys to be looking at this through the lens of trying to decipher whether or not you believe this really happened, because there is a large percentage of people that say this is just an urban legend. However, there is a couple details that make it really hard to just write off. Number one, you have a number of international ships and listening stations that all reported hearing this same distress signal, and it's a very unique distress signal that we'll get into. In addition, you have the U.S. Coast Guard and one of their, you know, fairly credible publications published a story about this case 5 years after it happened. And then you have the fact that this case has been around since 1947, it's been 70 plus years, and no one's officially debunked it. So let's dive in. In 1947...
Okay, so I'm inquisitive already. Okay, I'm not saying that it can't happen to where, you know, broadcast goes out. We have watched videos on my channel, specifically, of, like, there was one where this warning went over a broadcast station, like, the day before, like, a tragic accident happened, and nobody understands why it went up or anything like that. there's a few more. Oh, and like in history, like in school, you learn of the dude that got on the radio and said the aliens and stuff was coming and freaked all kinds of people out. So I don't want to say it's not possible, but for something on that big of a scale, and I don't know how secure the over the seas communications are, like from ships to other ships and naval bases and wherever they're going. I mean, I imagine if they're just on a DB or something like that. I don't know. We might have us a rabbit hole of a story. I'm excited.
Several Dutch, American, and English ships, along with a number of listening stations, picked up the strange distress signal that was coming from somewhere in the Indian Ocean. The distress signal, which was in Morse code, went like this.
An officer, including the captain, are dead. Lying in chart room and bridge. Possibly whole crew dead.
Then there was a burst of indecipherable Morse code, and then it ended with two words.
I die.
then silence. One ship that heard this distress signal was the Silver Star. It was an American vessel that was kind of patrolling the waterways around the coast of Malaysia. And with the help of other ships in and around the Indian Ocean and some of the listening stations, they were able to triangulate the location of this distress signal. And they pinpointed...
Now, is that easily done? And by that, I mean, I imagine there's not wires and all that stuff. You're going by, like, police would, the towers and all that. Is that easily done when you're in the middle of the freaking ocean? Like, and how far is your communication when you're in the ocean? Like, it can... I am very inquisitive today, people. If any of you out there know the answers to any of the questions I just asked, please leave them in the comments down below, because they are going to aggravate the living shit out of me until I know what they are. Thank you.
A ship called the SS Orang Medan that was located right at the end of the Strait of Malacca, which is the primary shipping lane between the Indian Ocean and the Pacific Ocean. And so this ship was basically drifting out towards the Indian Ocean. And so the first thing that the Silver Star does is they try to send a message back to the Orang Medan. But after...
Is this the man of Medan? I remember being on a boat. Bro, it's been a minute since I put... I don't know.
Numerous failed attempts. They decide, the captain of the Silver Star decides that we need to go investigate because something is obviously not right here. So the Silver Star tells all the other ships in the area, along with the other listening stations, that they are going to be the search party. They're going to reroute and head for the Orang Medan, because at this point, anybody that had heard that signal is saying, like, what do we do? Like, are we going to go investigate? Are you? After a couple of hours of heading straight for the Orang Medan, they see off in the distance the ship. You know, from the eyes of these very experienced sailors on the Silver Star, they knew almost immediately that this ship is dead in the water. It's just drifting, which is not a good sign, especially if you combine that with the signal they got. As they get closer and closer to this ship, it becomes creepier and creepier because they're looking up and in the bridge where, you know, the steering wheel would be, they can't make any person out. There's no one up there. There's nobody standing on the edge. I mean, they just sent this distress signal. You would think with a ship that's dead in the water that they would be lining the outside of the ship trying to signal someone down. But no, it's just quiet. No one on board, all lights off, just drifting, bobbing in the choppy waters of the Indian Ocean. And so as they get closer, they start blowing their whistle to try to attract anybody on the Orang Medan to signal them back. They're also doing more Morse code to try to get their attention again, not being picked up. And so finally, after all these failed attempts and...
See, bro, I'm going to go ahead and tell you, I've watched Ghost Ship. You put that bitch in full reverse and you run like shit. Like, you don't want to stay on there. There's going to be a creepy little girl. There's just going to be this thing that comes through and cuts people's heads off and shit. I don't want no part in that.
Just the general weirdness around it, the captain of the Silver Star decides we need to board this ship. So the Silver Star crew members, they knew before they boarded that almost definitely they were going to find something terribly wrong with this ship. There's just too many red flags about it. They were anticipating something bad, but I don't think that they were really prepared for just how bad this was going to be. So they board the ship, and right away on deck is a number of crew members that had passed away. They're all deceased. And the mystery really kicks in the position, the body position of all of the dead crew members. They were all on their back with their hands outstretched in front of them as if defending themselves from some unseen assailant above them. Even stranger is they had this look of abject terror on their face, as if...
What if they wasn't laying down doing that? What if they were standing up doing that and then they fell down? I mean, they're on the boat. It gets rocky. You know what I mean? I've seen Clash of the Titans, bro. I know some fucked up shit can happen. There's probably a Kraken out there, something that turns something into stone. God only knows. But no, seriously though, what if they are like not laying back at that moment? I mean, boats do move. If you're frozen in place and dead, you're going to fall. But what if you like go into your death pose and you're kind of looking like, instead of laying down, you're standing up. And the way he's looking, yeah, they could have still been looking up, but maybe not like up that way, you know? Maybe it was like up that way, like instead of being on your back. But what would do it?
The final moments before they died were just excruciatingly painful and terrifying. Even the dog was in a position with its teeth bared, looked like it was growling up into the sky. All of
not
them.
The puppy.
And so obviously the Silver Star crew members are, you know, shocked at what they find. And they're kind of looking at each of these dead
aliens. Definitely aliens. Or zombie infection. Maybe they're all going to turn into zombies. Either way, man, I would not be on this fucking boat. Zombie dogs, zombie people. Man, no.
Crew members, and they're like, what is going on? Mm. So they make their way up to the bridge, and everybody's also dead in the same position, basically fighting with some unseen assailant in their final moments before they pass. The person who had been sending out the distress signal had literally slouched over the telegraph. Like, their finger was literally on the telegraph. He's the only one that was not doing this. He was on the telegraph and had passed away in that position. So they go down into the bowels of the ship. Normally, inside of a steel ship in the boiler room, it's going to be pretty hot. There's no real ventilation to speak of. Not to mention, outside, it was over 100 degrees. They went down into the boiler room and down into the ship, and it was strikingly cold. Some of the crew members from the Silver Star said it felt like it might have been about 40 degrees Fahrenheit.
That's weird.
They found more crew members also passed away, also fighting with something in the air, with that look of abject terror on their face. So all of the crew has perished in this very bizarre way. There was no overt damage to the ship. It just appeared that the engine had been turned off, but ultimately the ship had no real damage to it at all. They couldn't find anything. The crew, despite meeting a fairly unfortunate end, also had no signs of outside injury, external injury. Something had obviously caused them all to perish, but there was no injuries outside their body.
What the hell?
In addition, all of them showed signs of rapidly decomposing. Considering they had just been tapped.
Now, depending on how he said it was pretty freaking warm, so I could understand like the ones up on deck decomposing faster than the ones below deck where it's like 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Well, that's pretty cold. I mean, that's almost freezing. You're going to stay fresher longer there. It's like being in the refrigerator. It's weird. Was the ones up on deck decomposing even faster than the ones below deck? Yes, no, maybe so. I don't know. That would be weird. Maybe it was a poison gas, and they're standing there looking at the gas come out. I'm like, you know, I've seen cartoons and I've seen movies that aren't real in any way, shape, or form, but possible.
Tapping away that
strange, dark, and mysterious people. I'm just telling you, like, that's this thing. Like, it's strange as dark, and I'm slightly scared and intrigued.
Press signal hours earlier, unless the person communicating the distress signal had been the last one alive for a long time, it doesn't really add up that they had decomposed as quickly as they had relative to when this distress signal was sent. So the captain of the Silver Star, taking into account all of the strangeness, decides not to touch any of the bodies, leave them where they are, get off the ship, tie a tow line to the Orang Medan, and tow it in. We're going to have experts look at this and figure out what happened. And so they attach the tow line, the crew members of the Silver Star, and as soon as they begin to move it, they notice, the crew of the Silver Star, that smoke has begun billowing out of the inside of the Orang Medan. And so, not taking any chances, they cut the tow line and they literally jump back onto the Silver Star right as the Orang Medan explodes. In fact, there was a quote which basically said it exploded with so much force that it was lifted out of the water entirely and then splashed back down and rapidly sank. So now you have no evidence. You have the testimony of the people that were on the ship.
What the fuck?
But other than that, you have no evidence. The ship is now gone. The captain of the Silver Star and his crew just have to go back to the mainland to try to make sense of what they just saw, because you have all these people that were involved and want to know what happened. And they're like, well, let me tell you, we saw this horrible thing on board and then it exploded and it disappeared. And so that's where the mystery kind of ends. But here we go. Let's get into what the primary critique is, because that's important to hear too. And then we'll hear the rebuttal, which I think is also pretty important. So people that believe this story is just a legend will point to the fact that there really isn't a good record of the SS Orang Medan ever existing. There's this one very important publication called Lloyd's Shipping Registers, where you would expect the Orang Medan to be registered, but they're not. Others will say that, well, Orang Medan translates to Man of Medan, and Medan is near Sumatra, and that's where they were registered. So they weren't in Lloyd's Shipping Registers, they were in another registry. But either way, they're...
Okay, in the game, I think it was a fucking virus. Started making people go crazy and see shit.
Start to the game, son of a bitch.
Look, any of my gamers out there, you know what I'm talking about, Man of Medan. Like, if you haven't played it, give it a play. It's kind of like a keep everyone alive, make choices, kind of scary game. It's fun. If you don't like it, you don't like it. It is what it is, but it's fun.
There is contention around whether or not this ship ever existed. But for those who say that this could be true, they say that, well, there's a good reason why those records don't exist, because someone's trying to cover it up. According to a German researcher who had spent decades covering the Orang Medan case, he published in the Death Ship on the South Seas, it's a publication from 1953, that the Orang Medan was transporting illegal materials, things like nitroglycerin and potassium cyanide. These are things used to create weapons. And there might have been a leak that led to the death of everyone on board. No physical injuries, but they passed away. And then also, after they tied that tow line, the materials could have detonated. You know, perhaps they detonated, that kind of thing. That still leads some questions, right? I mean, then how...
Or what if, like they said, you know, they was smuggling this stuff. And something did bust, killed everyone on board like a gas. But there was still stuff down there. The gas dissipated. Everyone's dead. There's no more gas. It leaked out everywhere. By the time they got there, it was gone. Okay? Just roll with me, bro. Roll with me here now. So the gas escapes whatever it's in, kills everyone on board. It eventually dissipates. It's gone. And then these people come on board. And they're like, bro, got like a nuke down there. They got some guns. They got this weird stuff in a tube. They was down there making Ninja Turtles in a one part, and they took it and put it on their ship and then blew up that ship with, you know, the whatever that they found, and just was like, eh, and went on about their day. I mean, just because, you know, someone came out there to do something good doesn't mean they ain't shady.
How did the Silver Star crew not also get exposed to these chemicals as soon as they got there? Either way, it's a fascinating story, and I hope that you took something from it. So if you haven't already, I would really appreciate it if you liked this video and you hit subscribe on my channel. I'm going to be...
Most definitely. Go back in time. Show this man some love. All right. No. Okay. This is where I really love my subscribers. Like, they know a lot of things, don't you? Each and every single one of y'all know something. But anyone has any more information on this story, please feel free to leave it in the comments. Hit me up on any of my social medias. Like, they're go to the YouTube channel. They're on the little thing. You can click them. I need to know more. Like, I had a feeling whenever I seen the SS Orang Medan that it was like the Man of Medan. Because, you know, I didn't know it was actually like a thing. You know what I mean. Don't judge me. It's been a long day, people. All right. I really enjoyed today's story. If you guys enjoyed today's story as much as I did, I hope you did. If not, what the hell's wrong with you? Please go down there. Leave a like. It really helps the channel grow. And I have really enjoyed all of the love I have been receiving here lately. Like, it is amazing. Thank each and every single one of you. Oh. All right. If y'all are a fan of the spooky, scary, strange things that just inquisitively tickle your brain pickle, think about subscribing. It's, as always, be good to one another. I'll see you in the next one. Oh, bye. What the hell? Like, man, it could have been anything. So much shit. And if they was doing something illegal, who's to say, like, you know, they'd some other boat didn't go there and like kill them and take their illegal shit to be even more illegal, because you know it's like Highlander, there can only be one. It's, you can't just have bad people everywhere. But yeah, most definitely, if you haven't played the games, go over, if you're a gamer and they intrigue you at all, play the game. It's actually quite fun. It's a game. It's not, you know.